Hello everyone, in this video, we will learn all about quadratic function. A quadratic function is given as f of x is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c, where a, b, and c are real numbers and a should never be zero. In this case, this f of x is considered as the function notation. And they are also considered as the dependent variable, while x are considered as the independent variables or the x values. Now, how are you going to identify whether a function is quadratic or not? So, I have here six different equations or functions. Let's identify whether they are quadratic or not. So, number one is yes, number two is no, number three is yes, four, no, five, no, and six is yes. So when you say quadratic function, it is a function whose highest exponent is 2. Now, what about if the given is a graph? How are you going to identify whether it defines a function or not? So I have here four different graphs. Number one is a quadratic function. Number two is not a graph of a quadratic function. Number three is not, and number four is yes. So when you say graph of quadratic function, it opens up or down. So that's why number one and number four, they are graphs of quadratic functions, while number two and number three, they are just graphs of quadratic equations but not a function. Okay, next. Now, what if the given are ordered pairs? How are you going to identify whether they are defining a quadratic function or not? So, there are two bases. Number one, there should be a common difference in x. And number two, the common second difference should be non-zero. For example, so these are the x values and their corresponding values are this one. So, in this case, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, there is a common interval. So let's identify the first difference in f of x. So that would be 3 minus 2 is 1, 4 minus 3 is 1, so it's consistent to be 1. So getting the second difference, that would be 0. So in this case, the second difference is 0. Therefore, it does not illustrate quadratic function. Let's have another example. So these are the x values, these are the y values. So in this case, there is a common interval. And the interval for x is still 1. So let's get the first difference. So this would be 4 minus 3 is 1, 7 minus 4 is 3, 12 minus 7 is 5, and 19 minus 12 is 7. Next, we will get the second difference, in which it is 2. So therefore, in this case, the second difference is non-zero. So therefore, this ordered pairs here define or illustrate a quadratic function. So again, for it to be considered defining a quadratic function, there should be a common difference in x, and the common second difference should be non-zero. So let's have another example. So let's have this. So in the values for x, there is a common interval. In this case, the common interval is 4. So let's get the first common difference. So 10 minus 1 is 9, 17 minus 10 is 7, 22 minus 17 is 5. Then we'll get the second difference. So 7 minus 9 is negative 2, 5 minus 7 is negative 2 as well. So therefore, the succeeding intervals here would also be negative 2. So 9 minus 2 is 7, 7 minus 2 is 5, and 5 minus 2 is 3, and 3 minus 2 is 1. 1 plus 9 is 10, 10 plus 7 is 17, 17 and 5 is 22, 22 plus 3. So the next point here would be 25. 25 plus 1, this would be 26. So in this case, this ordered pairs here, or table of values, define a quadratic function. Okay, another example. So in this case, there is a common interval in x in which it is 1. So let's get the first difference. So 1 minus 0 is 1, so this is 2, this is 3. Second difference would be 2 minus 1 is 1. 3 minus 2, it's still 1. So therefore, the succeeding intervals, it's also 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 plus 1 is 4. And 4 plus 1 is 5. So the same thing here. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 4 is 10. And 10 plus 5, it is 15. So in this case, this table of values here still defined a quadratic function. Another example. So in this case, there is still a common interval in x, which is 1. So let's get the first difference, in which it is 7. 27 minus 8 is 19. 64 minus 27 is 37. Let's get the second difference. In this case, the first is 12 minus 7 is 19 minus 7 is 12. 37 minus 19 is 18. So in this case, the second difference is no longer equal. So meaning it's no longer common. So in this case, this ordered pairs here do not define a quadratic function. Okay, last example. In this case, the values for x and the values for y, there is no common interval in x because x is repeated. So therefore, in this case, these ordered pairs here do not define a quadratic function. The standard form of quadratic equation is given as y is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c. The other form is the vertex form, in which it's given as y is equal to a quantity x minus h quantity squared plus k, where h and k is considered as the vertex. And the other way of finding the vertex, or h and k, is negative b over 2a for h, and for k, it's 4ac minus b squared all over 4a. So, let's have this one. Let's convert equations from standard to vertex and vertex to standard form. So, let's start with this. The quadratic function is x squared plus 4x minus 7. To rewrite this to vertex form, we will make use of completing the square. So in this case, group all x and constant will be at the other end. So half of 4 is 2, you square that, you add 4. So to maintain equality, we will also minus 4 at the end. So rewrite this to binomial form, we will have quantity x plus 2 squared, negative 7 minus 4, it's negative 11. Now, how to rewrite this to standard form. So let's reverse. So in this case, let's have this. So to go back to standard, we will just simply expand this one. So this is x squared plus 4x squared, 2 is 4, then minus 11. So in this case, x squared plus 4x, 4 minus 11 is negative 7. So we go back to the original given. Okay, another example. In this case, for number 2, there is already a value of a, which is not 1, it is 2. So to do this, we have to factor it out. So 2x squared, factor out 2, so that would become x squared. Then negative 12x divided by 2, we will have negative 6x. Then we have negative 3 outside. So at this point, complete the square. Half of 6 is 3. You square that, so you add 9. We add 9 here. We will also minus 9 at the end. But take note, there is 2 outside, so you have to multiply it. So simplifying, rewrite this to binomial form. So that would be 2. Square root of x squared is x. Square root of 9 is 3. Sine of the second term is negative. So negative 9 times 2 is negative 18. Minus 3, that would be negative 21. Now, let's go back to, from the vertex, let's go back to standard. So, still the same thing, expand this. So, this would be x squared minus 6x squared, 3 is 9, then minus 21. At this point, distribute 2 inside. So, 2x squared minus 12x plus 18 minus 21, simplifying 2x squared minus 12x minus 3, in which it's exactly the same as the original given. Now, so you might wonder, why is it there's a need for us to rewrite equations to vertex form? It is because we need to identify the vertex. Okay, so it's crucial when you graph. So, for example, x squared minus 8x plus 5. So the same thing, group of x terms and constant at the end. So half of 8 is 4, you square that, so this would be plus 16 and minus 16 at the end. So rewrite to binomial form. So square root of x squared is x, square root of 16 is 4, sine of the second term is negative. 5 minus 16, it's negative 11. So at this point, we can identify the vertex in which the value for h or x minus 4 is 0, so therefore x there is positive 4. Well, the value for k is negative 11. Okay, another example. Now, at this point, there is a value for a. So, to do this, before we complete the square, we have to factor it out. So, negative 3x squared by negative 3 is x squared. Negative 6x by negative 3, it's 2x. And plus 5. So, at this point, half of 2 is 1, square that. So, we added 1. So, we will minus 1. At the end, but there is negative 3 outside, so multiply. So, simplifying. So, rewrite this to binomial form. Square root of x squared is x. Square root of 1 is 1. Sine of the second term is positive. Negative 1 times negative 3 is positive 3 plus 5. So, we will end up with 8. So, at this point, the vertex here would be negative 1 and positive 8. So, that's the process on how to get the vertex. Now, take note, the vertex HK is considered as the highest or the lowest point of the parabola. Okay, there is another way of solving for HK. So, we can make use of this equation in which I gave earlier. So, for H, it's negative B over 2A, and for K, it's 4AC minus B squared over 4A. So, let's go back to this equation. So, we have this in the previous slide. So, complete the square. So, at this point, the vertex here is positive 4 and negative 11. So, we will make use of this formula in finding HK or finding the vertex. So, at this point, let's identify our ABC. So, our A is 1, our B is negative 8, and our C is positive 5. So, making use of this formula, so let's substitute. So, negative of B, so negative of negative 8, then 2, the value for A is 1. So, negative of negative 8, so that would be 8 divided by 2, we will end up with 4, which is exactly the same with this. Okay, another. For K, so the same thing, we will substitute. Our A is 1, our C is 5, then our B is negative 8 squared all over 4, and our A is 1. So 4 times 1 times 5, that's 20, minus negative 8 squared is 64 divided by 4. So this would be negative 44 divided by 4, so the value for K is negative 11, which is exactly the same with the process in using completing the square. So, take note of this one. Now, let's have the sample problem that involves vertex in real life. Now, what are the dimensions of the largest rectangular field that can be enclosed by 80 meters of fencing wire? What is its maximum area? Now, take note, the formula for perimeter is twice the length plus twice the of the width, in which the perimeter here is 80 meters. So, divide the entire equations by 2. So, therefore, we will get this. And the length can be expressed as 40 minus the width. Now, take note, area is length times width. So, in this case, our length can be substituted as 40 minus W, while the width is represented by W. So, distributing W to the terms inside, we will have negative W squared plus 40W. Completing the square, we will have this. So, factor out negative, so that would be W squared, 40 by negative, so that would be negative 40. Half of 40 is 20. You square that would become 400. So, we added 400, so we will minus 400 at the end. But take note, there is a negative outside, so therefore it's times negative. So rewrite this to binomial form. So square root of W squared is W, square root of 400 is 20, sine of the second term is negative, negative of negative 400 is positive 400. In this case, the vertex is positive 20 and 400. So therefore, the dimensions of the rectangular field would be 20 meters by 20 meters, while the maximum area that is represented by K is 400 meters squared. Okay, next. The height of the ball thrown into the air with an initial velocity of 9.8 meters per second from a height of 2 meters above the ground is given by the equation H of t, negative 4.9 t squared plus 9.8 t plus 2, where t is time in seconds that the ball has been in the air. Question. What is the maximum height did the object reach, and how long will it take for the ball to reach that height? So at this point, so let's rewrite this to vertex form, or the same thing. We can make use of the formula in finding H and K. So factor out negative 4.9. So this would become t squared. Positive 9.8 divided by negative 4.9 is negative 2t. Then we have plus 2 outside. So complete the squares. Half of 2 is 1. So square that, that would be 1. We will minus 1 at the end. But take note, this is there is negative 4.9 outside. So therefore, multiply. So simplifying, rewrite this to binomial form. So square root of t squared is t. Square root of 1 is 1. Sine of the second term is negative. Negative 1 times negative 4.9 is positive 4.9. Plus 2. That would be 6.9. So therefore, the vertex here would be 1 and 6.9, in which the 1 here is the time in seconds. Well, 6.9, that would be the maximum height. So the meaning of this, the ball will reach 6.9 as the highest height, and it would take 1 second for the ball to reach that height. How to graph quadratic function. But before that, let's have this one. So in this case, this parabola opens upward. If a parabola opens upward, it means the vertex is considered as the minimum point or the lowest point. And the value for A is positive. Now, another case is if a parabola opens downward, it means the vertex will be the highest or the maximum point, and the value for A is negative. So take note of this one. Now, some of the basic properties when you graph quadratic functions. There's 2 points here, they are considered as the x-intercepts. This point here is considered as the vertex, in which it could be the lowest point or it could be the highest point. Okay, another term is the axis of symmetry, in which it is a line passing through the center of the parabola, or it passes through the vertex. Okay, now there are steps that we need to follow when we graph quadratic functions. Number one, it's very important to rewrite it in vertex form, or simply identify the vertex. You can make use of the other way of finding H and K. Okay. Then, make a table of values in which the vertex should be at the center. Assign values for X and solve for Y. Plot the points in the Cartesian plane and connect the points with a smooth curve. Let's have an example. We're given here y is equal to x squared minus 2x minus 3. In this case, let's rewrite this to vertex form. So complete the square. Half of negative 2 is 1. Square it. That would be 1. We add 1 here, so we will minus 1 at the end. Rewrite to binomial form. Square root of x squared is x. Square root of 1 is 1. Sine of the second term is negative. So negative 3 minus 1 is negative 4. At this point, the vertex is positive 1 and negative 4. Now, how come it is the minimum point? It's because it opens upward. How will we know if it opens upward? It's because the value for A here is positive. Okay, next. Write this in the table of values. So 1 and this will be 4. So to the right of 1, we'll have 2 and 3. And to the left of 1, we will have 0, negative 1. Although you can extend further to the right, you can also extend further to the left. Now, how are we going to identify the values for y here? So using 2, we can make use of the original equation or we can make use the vertex form. So let's substitute. So our x is 2, so this would be 2 squared minus 2 times 2 minus 3. So this would be 4 minus 4, so this would be negative 3. So if our x is 2, our y is negative 3. So the same process if we will have x as 3, and the same process if we will have x as 0 or negative 1. So we will have this values. Okay, next. We will plot this in the Cartesian plane. So we have here negative 1, 0. We have 0, negative 3. We have 1, negative 4. We have 2, 3. And we have 3, 0. Next to this, we will connect this with a smooth curve. So therefore, this will be our graph. So our axis of symmetry, it will be at the center and it will pass through x is equal to 1 or x is equal to h. Okay, so that will be the equation of our axis of symmetry. So our domains here will be the values of x in which we can extend infinitely to the right and to the left. So therefore, it is infinity. Well, the range, these are values of y, which is from the lowest to the highest possible value of y. So in this case, our lowest is at negative 4 until positive infinity because our graph can extend infinitely at the top. So take note of this. Okay, another example. Now in this case, we have negative x squared plus 4x minus 1. So factor out negative 1. So negative x squared by negative is x squared. 4 by negative 1 is negative 4x. Complete the square. Half of negative 4 is 2. Square it plus 4, then minus 4. But take note, we have negative 1 outside, so negative 1. So rewrite to binomial form. So square root of x squared is x. Square root of 4 is 2. Sine of the second is negative. Negative 4 times negative 1 is positive 4. Minus 1 would be positive 3. At this point, the opening here is down. So how will we know if it's downwards? It's because the value for a is negative. And the vertex here would be positive 2 and positive 3. And that would be a maximum point. Maximum because it opens downward. So write this in the table of values. At the center would be 2 and 3. To the right of 2 would be 3 and 4. To the left would be 1 and 0. So, we'll make use of 3. X is equal to 3. So, substitute in the original equation. So, negative 3 squared plus 4 times 3 minus 1. So, simplifying, this would be negative 9 plus 12. Then, minus 1, we will end up with 2. So, the same process if we will have X as 4, 1, or 0. So take note, when you observe here, as long as the intervals in x is constant, take note, at the vertex it's 2, 3, to the right is 2, negative 1, it should be the same to the other side, in which it is also 2 and negative 1. So we'll plot this in the Cartesian planes. 0, negative 1, 1 and 2, this is 2, 3, this is 3, 2, and this is 4, negative 1. Connect with a curve and draw the axis of symmetry. So we will have there x is equal to h, in which the value is 2. So that's the equation of the axis of symmetry. So take note, equation of AOS. It should be a line. So the domains here, so still extend infinitely. We can extend to the right. We can also extend to the left. So the range here, so again, when you say range, starts from the lowest. So the lowest here is infinite. That's why it's negative infinity until the highest height, which is 3. Now let's try to observe the movement of the quadratic functions or the graph of quadratic functions as the value for A and B and C changes. So let's start with A, which is the coefficient of the quadratic terms. Now take note, if the value for A is negative, so our graph is opening downwards. Now again, if the value for A is positive, the opening of our parabola is upwards. So take note of that. So upward, negative, it's downwards. Now let's observe if the value for B changes. So for example, for B, if the value for B is positive, so the vertex is moving to the left side. Now, what happens if the value for B is negative? So take note when you observe, if the value for B is already negative, the vertex will shift to the right side. Again, if the value for B is negative, the vertex is located at the right side. But if the value for B is positive, the vertex will be located at the left side. Now, what happened for C? Now, for C, if the value for C is positive, so the bigger it is, the higher it will go. Now, if the value for B or C is getting smaller, it will also go down. Again, if the value for C is getting higher, the vertex is also moving up. But if the value for C is getting smaller, the location of the vertex is going down. Okay, another thing. Now, when you observe for the value for A, for the absolute value for A, so take note, if the value for A is increasing, so the bigger the value for A, the narrower the opening will be. But if the value for A is getting smaller, but not negative, no, or if it's negative, it should be, you consider the absolute value of it, the opening of the parabola is getting wider. Again, if the value for A increases, the bigger the value for A, the narrower the opening will be. But the smaller the absolute value for A, the wider the opening of the parabola will be. So take note of that. That's how the value for A, B, and C affects the movement of the parabola. Implications of A, H, and K. Now take note, we had this. If the value for A is negative, so it will open downwards. If it's positive, it will open upwards. Take note of that. Okay, another. What about this one? As the value for A increases, the narrower the opening will be. So we also had this in the previous slide. Okay, this one. So in this case, the smaller the value for A, the wider the opening will be. Okay, another one. In this case, what happened if the K is positive or if the K is negative? So if the K is positive, so the graph will also move up. If the K is negative, it will go down. So the K, it is related also with C. Okay, so take note of that. It goes up or it goes down. Now, what about for the value for H? So what happened? So if H is positive, so plus H, it will move to the left. Plus 5, it will move 5 units to the left. If the H is negative, so negative 3, it will move 3 units to the right. So H is positive, vertex will slide to the right. If it's negative, it will slide to the left. Okay, this one. So original is y equals x squared. So minus 2 plus 4. So, meaning it will move to the right 2 units and 4 units upward. So, for number 3, positive 3 and minus 4. So, in that case, so move negative 3 to the left and move down negative 4. For number 4, it's the vertex here is 1 and negative 3. So, move to the right 1 unit and 3 units downwards. Then, for the last graph, so that would mean move 4 units to the left and 3 units upward. So, to graph y is equal to x minus h squared plus k, slide the graph horizontally h units and vertically k units. Now, let's have this one. Give the translation of this. The original graph is 3x squared. If it's shifted 4 units downward, so that would be y is equal to 3x squared minus 4. For number 2, it will shift 2 units to the left. So that would be 4 quantity x plus 2 squared. 2 units to the left, so that would mean plus 2. Because again, in identifying h, we have to get the negation of it. Next, number 3. 5 units up and 2 units to the right. So 2 units to the right, so that would mean minus 2. 5 up, so therefore plus 5. Okay, next, number 4. 2 units down, so take note it's downward, and 6 units to the left. To the left, so therefore that would mean plus 6, and 2 units down, so therefore it's minus 2. Then, number 5. Half unit upward and half unit to the left. So to do this, that would mean plus 1 half. Then, half units upward, so therefore still plus 1 half. Now, let's have this one. Carl hit a volleyball at 3 feet above the ground with an initial velocity of 32 feet per second. The path of the ball is given by the function s of t is negative 16t squared plus 32t plus 3, where s is the height of the ball at t seconds. So, let's have this one. What kind of function is used to model the path of the volleyball? So, definitely it is parabola. Parabola that opens downward. It's because it is negative and the highest exponent is 2. Identify the maximum height reached by the ball. So, take note, we have this equation. So, factor out negative 16. So, 32 by negative 16 is negative 16. Half of 2 is 1. So, square that. That would be 1. Minus 1 here, but times negative 16. So, simplifying further, square root of t squared is t. Square root of 1 is 1. Sine of the second is negative. Negative 16 times negative 1 is positive 16. So, plus 3, that would be 19. So, the vertex would be 1 and 19. So, what is represented by the maximum point of the graph? Or what's the meaning of the vertex? So, the highest height here is 19 feet, and it would take 1 second to reach the maximum height. So, that's the meaning of the vertex. So, this will be our graph. No? So, it opens downward. Okay, next. A ball on the playing ground was kicked by Jasper. The parabolic path of the ball is traced by the graph below. So take note, this is the graph. So horizontal distance in meters, and this is the height in meters. So question, what is the initial height of the ball? So take note, the ball started on the ground, so therefore 0. What's the maximum height reached by the ball? So it's somewhere here, so therefore it is 10 meters. Now, determine the horizontal distance that corresponds to maximum to the maximum distance. So, the maximum distance is located here. So, it's 10 meters above the ground if the ball is 6 meters from the starting point. Question, how far does the ball travel horizontally before it hits the ground? So, therefore, the answer here is 12 meters. Finding the equation of quadratic function. Now, I have here three different graphs. So we have here the red, the black, and the blue. Take note, the red touches the graph at 2 points, or the x-axis at 2 points. The second graph touches the x-axis at 1 point, while the third graph never touches the x-axis. Now take note, the number of times the graph touches the x-axis corresponds to the number of zeros. So in this case, for graph, the red graph, it has two real zeros, or two unequal roots. Well, number two, since it touches at 1 point only, so it has one real zero, or the two zeros here are real and equal. While in graph number three, the zeros here are basically imaginaries. Now, let's have this one. This is a graph of x squared minus 2x minus 3. Let's answer this one. What is the vertex of the graph? So the vertex here is located at positive 1 and negative 4. Number 2, at what values of x does the graph intersect the x-axis? So take note, the graph intersects with the x-axis at negative 1 and positive 3. Question, what do you call negative 1 and positive 3? They are considered as the zeros of quadratic, or basically the roots of quadratic. Next, what is the value for y at these values of x? So at this point, the value for y here would be 0. That's why they are considered as the x-intercepts. Now, how to find the zeros or the roots of quadratic? So just the same how we did in quadratic function, there are three ways. Number one is by factoring. So if we're given this, factors of 2 in order to get negative 3. So that would be minus 2 and minus 1. So the first root is 2 and the second root is positive 1. Okay, another, solve by completing the square. So given this, so the very first thing, equate to 0 and solve for x. So, half of 4 is 2, so square that would be 4. So, transfer negative 2 to this other end, other side, added 4. Rewrite to binomial form, get the square root to both sides. So, therefore, x would be negative 2 plus and minus square root of 6. The first root would be negative 2 plus square root of 6. The second root is negative 2 minus square root of 6. Next, this one is by using the quadratic formula. So given this, identify our a as 1, b 2, and c negative 5. Using the quadratic formula, let's substitute negative 2. This would be 2 squared, our a is 1, our c is 5, and 2. So simplifying, 4 minus 20, that would be negative 16. Square root of negative 16, that would be 4i. Take note, our radicand is negative. So the first root would be negative 2 plus 4i over 2, that's negative 1 plus 2i. The other one, that would be negative 1 minus 2i. So again, in finding the zeros, there are three ways. You can use factoring, completing the square, or use the quadratic formula. Now, given this, so the zeros here are located at 3, negative 1. And this one, the zero is located at negative 2. So take note again, if the graph touches the x-axis at 1 point, so meaning it is basically a perfect square trinomial. Next, if it never touches the x-axis, it is actually, the roots are imaginary. Okay, next. Now, at this point, the zeros are given. So, let's identify its quadratic function. So, if the zeros are negative 3 and 2, so with this, so that would be x minus negative 3 and x minus 2. So, that would mean x plus 3 and x minus 2. So, simplifying, x squared plus x minus 6. So, where a is any non-zero constant. Okay, another. What if the given is a radical, just like this one? So, irrational roots can be written as the product of linear factors. So, that would be x is equal to 3 plus and minus square root of 2 over 3. Cross multiply, we will have this. So, transfer 3 to the other end, and squaring both sides, so square 3x minus 3, that would mean 9x squared minus 18x plus 9 equals 2. So simplifying further, transfer 2 to the other end and simplify. This will be our final equation. Okay, next. What if the given is imaginary or the roots are imaginary? You give its quadratic function. So the same process how we did example 2. So that would be x is equal to 2 plus and minus 3i. So transfer 2 to the other end. So that would become minus 2. Squaring both sides. So square the first, multiply the first and the second, times 2 and square the second. So at this point, take note, I squared is basically negative 1. So combining like terms, we will end up with f of x is equal to x squared minus 4x plus 13. So take note of this one. Given the table of values, find its quadratic equation. So step 1. Substitute 3 ordered pairs in the equation y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. Okay, take note at this point, when you select ordered pairs, you go for smaller numbers. So at this point, we will consider negative 1 and negative 5. So substitute in this equation, our x is negative 1 and our y is negative 5. So simplify, we will get this, label this as equation 1. Next, we'll go for 2 and 1. At this point, our x is 2 and our y is 1. Simplifying, we will get this and label this as equation 2. Okay, next, the other one would be 1 and 3. So our x is 1 and our y is 3. Simplify and label as equation 3. Next, step 2. Solve for a, b, and c. So to do this, we will combine equations 1 and 3. So why 1 and 3? It's because for 1 and 3, we can eliminate more than 2, actually, letters. So at this point, we can eliminate A and C by subtracting. So A minus A, you can cancel. Negative B minus B, it's negative 2B. And C minus C, you can also cancel. Negative 5 minus 3, that would be negative 8. So, solving for B, right, B is 4. Next, substitute B in equation 1. So, take note, in equation 1, the B here should be 4. Right, we can have C here, A plus C equals negative 1, or we can have C as negative A minus 1. Next, substitute C using equation 2. So, our equation 2 here is 4A plus 2B plus C equals 1. Take note, our B is 4, and we will substitute C with negative A minus 1 so that we can combine A, and only one variable is left. So simplifying, 4A plus 8, this is minus A minus 1 equals 1. So simplifying, it's 3A equals 1 minus 7, or 3A is negative 6, or A is negative 2. Again, we already have the value for A, and we have B. Now, at this point, we will solve for C using equation 1. So, at this point, our A is negative 2, and our B is 4. So, simplifying, our C would be negative 5 plus 6. Our C is positive 1. Okay, last step. Write the equation in the form ax squared plus bx plus c. So at this point, our a is negative 2, our b is positive 4, and our c is 1. So therefore, this ordered pairs here can be derived from the quadratic function y is equal to negative 2x squared plus 4x plus 1. Okay, that's one. Find the equation of the quadratic function from the graph below. So take note, using the standard equation in which the vertex is 2, negative 3, we have another point here which is negative 1 and 0. So find the value for A. So let's substitute. So our y is 0, our x is negative 1, A is unknown, our h is positive 2, so that would be minus 2, and our k is negative 3. So negative 1 minus 2 is negative 3 squared. So simplifying, That would be 9a equals 3, or a is 1/3. So therefore, the quadratic function for this graph would be y is equal to a, or a is 1/3, quantity x minus 2 squared minus 3. Another. The vertex is located at 4, 3, and it passes through 3, 5. So the same thing. So our y is 5, our x is 3, our h is 4, and our k is 3. So simplifying, our a would be 2. So our equation would be y is equal to 2, then x minus 4 squared plus 3. Okay, last example. So the vertex is located at negative 2, 4, and it passes through 0, 2. So the same thing. Our y is 2, our x is 0, our h is negative 2, and our k is 4. So simplifying, our a would become negative 1/2. And this will be our equation. Now let's have this sample problem that involves roots of quadratic functions. Take note, the path of the golf ball follows a trajectory. So it's like this. So the ball, okay, it hits the ground 400 meters away. So this would be 400 meters away from the starting point, and it just overshoots a tree. So it passes through a tree, which is 20 meters high. And the tree is located 300 meters away from the starting point. So question, find the equation determined by the path of the golf ball. So the same process. So take note, the coordinate of this would be 320, which will be considered as our vertex. So in this case, our y would be 0, our x is 400, our h here is 300, and our k is 20. So simplifying, we will end up with this. So our equation here would be y is equal to negative 1 over 500 quantity x minus 300 squared plus 20. Okay, another. Let's have this. This is the profit in a certain banana plantation. Take note, what is the vertex? So take note, in the horizontal axis, that's the number of weeks of waiting. And the vertical axis, these are the total profit. So what is the vertex? So it's the highest point. It's here. So that would be 2 and 1,280. So what is the meaning of the vertex? So it means that after 2 weeks of waiting, the profit, the maximum profit would be 1,280. Now what happened if the plantation will wait for 10 weeks. So if they will wait for 10 weeks before they will harvest, their profit would be 0. If they will wait only for 1 week before they harvest, or waiting time is 1 week, their profit would only be 1,260. So what is the equation of the function? So at this point, we will use 10 and 0. So 10 weeks of waiting will be 0 profit. So let's substitute. Our x is 10, our y is 0, our h is 2, and our k is 1,280. So simplifying, we'll have a is negative 20. So the equation would be y is equal to negative 20 quantity x minus 2 squared plus 1,280. So that would be all about quadratic functions. Thank you.